Hello students, I am Prasanna. In this video I am going to explain 4.7 exercise of unit 4, lines and angles. In my last video I have discussed about transversal and angles made by the transversal and the transversal on parallel lines. Now continuation of that 4.7, in that first question is fill up the blanks. First one, the line which intersects two or more lines at distinct points. This is the definition of what? Transversal. A line which intersects two or more lines at different points, distinct points, is called what? Transversal. So what is the first answer? Transversal. Okay. Now coming to second one. If the pair of alternate integer angles are equal, then the lines are. See, whenever the pair of alternate interior angles, means alternate interior angles are equal or alternate exterior angles are equal, or if the corresponding angles are equal, or interior angles on the same side of a transversal are supplementary, then the lines are parallel. We can say the lines are parallel. Okay. Coming to next one, the sum of interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, then the lines are parallel. Here, if these two lines, interior angles on the same side, if the sum of these two is 180 degrees, then we can call the two lines are parallel. So, once again I am repeating children, when we can say the two lines are parallel? If alternate interior angles are equal, alternate exterior angles are equal, if corresponding angles are equal, if sum of interior angles on the same side of a transversal is 180, or sum of exterior angles on the same side of a transversal is 180, then we can say the two lines are parallel. Coming to fourth one, if two lines intersect each other, then number of common points they have. Two lines means intersects. So how many common points you are going to get here? Only one common point. So the number of common points they have is 1. So these are the four blanks in the first question. Coming to second question children, in the adjacent figure the lines L and M are parallel. Already they gave condition that the two lines are parallel and N is a transversal. Fill in the blanks for all situations given below. So whenever the two lines are parallel, here we'll have alternate interior angles are equal, alternate interior angles and alternate exterior angles. Corresponding angles are equal. These three types of angles are equal. When the two lines are parallel, we can take alternate interior angles are equal, alternate exterior angles are equal, and the corresponding angles are equal. And next, interior angles on the same side of a transversal are supplementary. Means sum of interior angles. Here on the same side, 2 plus 3 equal to 180, 7 plus 6 is also 180, and you can take 1 plus 4 as 180, 8 plus 5 as 180 degrees when the lines are parallel. So coming to first question, if angle 1 is 80, then what is angle 2? Here they have given 1 is 80, then what is 2? First see, 1 and 2 forms what type of angles? If you see that 1 and 2 form linear pair. Linear pair is what? Sum of two adjacent angles is 180. So here angle 1 plus angle 2 as 180, because it forms linear pair. Linear pair. And angle 1 is given as 80 degrees plus angle 2 equal to 180. Then what is angle 2 children here? 180, this when transpose 80 to that side, it will become minus 80. Then angle 2 is what? 100 degrees. So here you got angle 2 as 100 degrees. Here, angle 1 plus angle 2 equal to 180 degrees. Since it is a linear pair. Okay. Next, coming to second question. If angle 3 is 45 degrees, then what is angle 7? What is the relation between 3 and 7? If you see, 1 is either 3 is on the right side of transversal, 7 is on the left side of transversal, and they are not adjacent, so both are interior. So we can say they are alternate interior angles. So whenever the lines are parallel, alternate interior angles are equal. So here angle 3 equal to angle 7. These are nothing but alternate interior angles. So you can simply write, if angle 3 is 45, then angle 7 is also 45 degrees. Okay. Next, third one. If angle 2 is 90, then what is angle 8? What is the relation here, 2 and 8? See, their point of intersection is here. If you see, both are opposite, vertically opposite angles. So whenever the two lines intersect, always the vertically opposite angles are equal. So here, if angle 2 is 90, then what is angle 8, children? 90 degrees. Here, angle 2 is angle 8. These are nothing but vertically opposite angles. Next, fourth one. If angle 4 is 100, then what is angle 8? What is the relation here, 4 and 8? If you see, 4 is on the right side of a transversal, 8 is on the left side of a transversal. Okay, so they are both are exterior angles. So here 8 and 4 forms alternate exterior angles. So whenever the lines are parallel, alternate exterior angles are equal. So if angle 4 is 100, we can say that angle 8 is also 100 degrees. Here angle 4 equal to angle 8, these are nothing but alternate exterior angles. Coming to third question, children. Find the measure of x, y and z in the figure where L is parallel to BC. They are given that here this L is parallel to BC. We have to find the value of x, y and z. Okay. Now if you see this figure, children, this line is L. And this is BC. Okay. And if I take this as a transversal, means AB as a transversal, here 75 is here and the Y is here. Then what type of angles they are? Already they are given that L is parallel to BC, means the lines are parallel. If the lines are parallel, we can take corresponding angles as are equal, alternate interior angles are equal, alternate exterior angles are equal, and the sum of interior angles on the same side of a transversal are supplementary. If you see here, 75 and Y forms what? See, they are both are interior and either side of a transversal, and they are not adjacent. So clearly we know that these two angles form alternate interior angles. So if the lines are parallel, alternate interior angles are equal. Therefore, Y is also 75. So, Y equal to 75 degrees. Y, here this forms alternate interior angles. Next, if you see here one more figure, line L is here and BC is down. If I take AC as a transversal, okay, AC as a transversal, here is 45 and here is Z. So 45 and Z forms what? Both are interior and either side of a transversal and they are not adjacent. So 45 and Z also form alternate interior angles. So z is nothing but 45 here. So these also form alternate interior angles. Now you got the value of y as 75, value of z as 45. Here we need to find the value of x. If you see that figure, it is triangle and all the three angles are given. The three interior angles are x, y, z. And you know the sum, angle sum property, children. The sum of the three angles in a triangle is what? 180 degrees. So, x plus y plus z equal to 180 degrees. This is what? Angle sum property. Sum of the three interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Here x, we need to find what is y, 75, and what is z, 45, equal to 180 degrees. So x plus 75 plus 45, 120, equal to 180. So x is nothing but 180 minus 120. That is x equal to 60. So here finally we got the y value as 75. Z value as 45 and x value as 60. Now coming to fourth question, ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AB is parallel to DC. Here they told AB is parallel to DC and AD is parallel to BC. Here this line is parallel to this side and this line is parallel to this side. Okay, find angle B, angle C, angle D, and they gave the angle A as 50 degrees. See, if we not consider the transversal, we can take this as a parallelogram, children, because a quadrilateral in which both pairs of opposite sides parallel means we call it as parallelogram. In parallelogram we can take opposite angles as equal, but we are dealing with the chapter lines and angles. We are dealing with the transversal in this topic. Okay, now how to find using transversal here. Now if you observe the figure, children, here this line and this line are parallel. Here this is DC and this is AB. Okay, if I take this as a transversal, like AD is a transversal. Okay, suppose this is D, AD is a transversal. Okay, now this is 50 degrees and here is a D. So what does it form? What type of angles they are? Both are interior and both are on the same side of a transversal. So we can say these two angles as interior angles on the same side of a transversal. But when the lines are parallel, what is the condition? If the lines are parallel, we can take interior angles on the same side of a transversal as supplementary. Means this D plus 50 equal to 180 degrees. So here D, angle D plus 50 degrees equal to 180, because they form interior angles on the same side of a transversal or supplementary. Or you can write sum of interior angles on the same side of a transversal is 180 also. Now what is D here? D is nothing but 180 degrees minus 50. That is D is nothing but 130 degrees. Okay, here you got D as 130 degrees. Now they gave here this line is also parallel to this line. This is AD and this is BC. Okay, now if I take these two lines as parallel, this will be what? Transversal. And here is 50 and here is B. So what does this 50 and B forms? Same. Interior angles on the same side of a transversal are supplementary. So 50 plus angle B equal to 180 degrees. This forms same. Interior angles on the same side of a transversal is supplementary. Now what is B now? Here B is nothing but, B is equal to, angle B is equal to 180 degrees minus 50 degrees. That is angle B is nothing but 130 degrees. So here you got angle B also 130 degrees. Then what about that C now? We need to find the C here. Same. DC and AB I am taking. And this is what? Transversal. Here is C and here is B. What about angle C and B? Same. Interior angles on the same side of a transversal. And here we got B value as 130 degrees. So here next one is B plus angle B angle C equal to 180 degrees. Same step you need to write here. Interior angles on the same side of a transversal are supplementary. So what is B here? 130. 130 plus angle C is 180. Angle C is what? 180 degrees minus 130. That is angle C equal to 50 degrees. So you got the value of C as 50 degrees. Coming to fifth question. In a given figure, L and M are intersected by a transversal M. Here this line is L and this is M and this is a transversal. It is intersecting at the two points here and here, okay? And is L is parallel to M? They are asking whether these two lines are parallel or not. If you observe, see here the two angles are given 100 and 80. What type of the angles they are here? If you see, both are exterior. 100 and 80 both are exterior angles. And they are on the same side of the transversal. Here, when we add 100 and 80, you are getting 180. So, here whenever exterior angles on the same side of a transversal is 180 degrees, then we can say the lines are parallel. If interior angles on the same side of a transversal is 180 also, then the lines are parallel. Okay? Now here, when you add this, 100 plus 80. How much? 180 degrees. Here, what type of angles they are? Exterior angles. When exterior angles on the same side of a transversal is 180. Supplementary also you can write. Supplementary, we can say the lines are parallel. So we can write here L is parallel to M. Therefore, L is parallel to M. Suppose if I take this as 100 vertically opposite angles and this as 80 vertically opposite angles, then also you get the interior angles on the same side of a transversal as 180. Then we can say the lines are parallel. Or if it is 80, what about this 100 by taking linear way? By that, this and this angles form corresponding angles, and we can write if the corresponding angles are equal, then the lines are parallel. Any way you can write, children, you can prove in any way. Coming to sixth sum, children, find angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D and angle E in the figure, give reason. And one more again in the question that two arrow marks pointing on the same way are parallel lines. Okay? If you see this figure, now I will consider only up to here, children. This line and this line are what? Arrow marks indicating C, downside. These two are what? Parallel lines. Okay? And if I take this one, it is a transversal. And here this is what? A and this is 50 degrees. So what type of angles they are? A and 50 here? Alternate interior angles. So here when the two lines are parallel, alternate interior angles and alternate exterior angles are equal. So I can take A as 50, angle A as 50, since they are alternate interior angles. So A we got as 50. Now I remove this 8 and take this 2 now. Here it is like this. These two arrow marks indicating on parallel lines. And this is a transversal. Here is B and here is 50. So what type of angles they are? The lines are parallel here. 50 and B forms alternate interior angles. So here I can take angle B is also 50 because they form alternate interior angles. Okay. Next, consider now B and C. Here, these two. If I see here, if you take this, two lines are parallel. B and C forms what? Alternate interior angles. So angle B equal to angle C. Here they are alternate interior angles. Then what is C? Here C is also 50 because since angle B is 50 degrees. We got 50 now here. Angle A as 50 you got, angle B as 50. Now angle C is also 50. Now we will go for D. If you take this here, C and D. C and D forms what? Same alternate interior angles. So angle C equal to angle D. Here alternate interior angles. Okay. Therefore angle D is also 50. Since angle C is 50. If angle C is 50, angle D is also 50. Next. Coming to here, D and E. D and E forms what? Same. Angle D equal to angle E. Alternate interior angles. Therefore, angle E is also 50 degrees since angle D is 50. So here, if you see, all the angles are here alternate interior angles. So therefore, angle A is 50, angle B is 50, angle C is 50, angle D is 50 and angle E is 50. Here, instead of taking D and E, we can take E and 50 also. Here also, they form alternate interior angles. So by this sum, children, we have completed fourth unit, lines and angles. Hope everyone understood.